Adobe Express has a new beta program that anyone can join, and its features are perfect for creators. Hey everyone, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can enjoy these Adobe Express features, then you can too. This is just one of the many new features in the Adobe Express beta that you can use for free. Now, in full transparency, I am an Adobe Express ambassador, and this video is sponsored by Adobe. However, I've been making Adobe Express content for a while now, and I'm super excited to talk about this beta. This beta is free for anyone to try, and you can do so via the link in the description down below. A few things to note is the beta is only available on the web version at the time of this video, but a mobile version is coming soon, and I'll make sure to update the pinned comment down below when it's here. Also, just because this is a beta version, that doesn't mean you can't use the original version of Adobe Express. It just means that the files you create in the beta version stay in the beta version. With all that out of the way, let's get started.
Welcome to the Adobe Express beta. Now, because this is a beta program, there might be some things that aren't in the usual version of Adobe Express. If there's anything missing or you run into any issues, in the top right-hand corner here, you can click on this to report a bug, or you can join their Discord for feedback. Now, there's so many new cool things you can do. First off, the homepage is completely changed. You can now see what they recommend, as well as sort by social media, video, photo, documents, marketing, or use their cool new generative AI. And I know there are some people out there who are unsure about AI. I'll have resources in the description down below on what Adobe is doing to really kind of reassure you, like it reassured me, on what they're doing and how they're thinking about AI. With that said, let's go ahead and get started with one of the coolest things they offer, which is text to image. So if you're ever struggling with maybe a background or you need an image for your video, this is such a cool tool. So let's say I wanted a ship in a bottle, high detail with a robot crew. This is coming off the top of my head. I'm gonna hit generate this text to image and watch what happens. Now, the cool thing about text to image is that you can resize this. You can have different fonts, different styles. As you can see, it's generating as I talk. And looking here, I don't necessarily see the robots, but this is still a really high detailed ship. If I look here, I guess there's some robots. Maybe there's a different version I could look at and we can see a little bit more. But it is really cool what we get just from the top of our heads, right? And you can choose movements. There's different like styles. You can load more. You can do so much with just this generative AI. There's so many different ways we can do it, but that's just a small taste of generative AI. Now, eagle-eyed viewers may have noticed everything's been moved to the left-hand side. Here we have our stuff. So this is the stuff that is synced with the Adobe cloud. So you may also notice this is Photoshop files. We're going to go all the way back to the beginning of the Express beta, click on recommended, but you can get there in different ways. The cool thing now is you can bring either Illustrator or Photoshop files within Adobe Express. So I know a lot of YouTubers give Photoshop files for free away. You can now bring them in to Adobe Express, even if you don't have Photoshop, and you can use them. So if I click on this, then I'm going to go ahead and go to Photoshop files. This is where obviously I have all of my stuff. I'm going to go ahead and click on this Photoshop file and bring it in. This is actually for my short film. It's a very simple, you know, PSD. But as you can see, it's going really quick. And even though this was a bigger file, it loads really quickly as well. So it's complete. It's now in our files. And if I click open in editor, I can edit this file even more. It's been able to identify different parts that were segments. So let's say that I wanted to match these laurels to be one side. I am editing a Photoshop file in Adobe Express, but now I have an editable version that I can use on the go. And you can do the same thing for Illustrator, and I can really, you know, enhance this if I want. Maybe I want to add more elements. Maybe I want to change the text. There's so much you can do. But again, I want to keep moving. I want to make sure we show off all the cool things. The next thing I want to show is how I did that effect with the puppet version of me, if you will. So if you go into video, you may notice there's a quick action to animate from audio. So the way I was able to do this was I found an avatar that I thought fit me best. First, I'd recommend choosing the size. You have multiple different resize options. Now, this is not for a YouTube short. This is for my main YouTube. So I would put it in 16:9. Background, you can choose one of the many pre-existing ones. Maybe I want to be in the dock for that ship in the bottle earlier, or you can upload your own image. And I just took a still from when I wasn't in frame earlier. And then, you know, you can pick a different character. You can choose its size. You can click on it, choose the size. You know, I try to match the frame I was. And you can either upload your own audio, which I did earlier, or you can record it and use the enhanced speech. This just says it makes voice recording sound as if they were recorded in a professional studio. You can click that. I just uploaded by clicking here. Keep in mind, it does say you can't have longer than 2 minutes, and there's a 1 gigabyte max per upload. So that's how I was able to make this character, just by uploading and using the Adobe Express beta. It is incredible, and there's so much more. And I really hope you click that link in the description and give it a try. We're not even done. So they now have more amazing video features. So we already saw the quick actions. You can now do stuff with stories. You can animate them in cool and unique ways. So you can also do shorts here. This is a great example. It is a, they have videos here. These are stock videos. And of course, Adobe Stock comes with Adobe Express. There's images that you can use. There's also Instagram Reels, right? So if there are things that you want to kind of customize for your story, you see something you like and you want to replace it, this could be a great example. Let's say you're doing a live stream and there's something here you really like. You can easily remove some of this background footage by clicking on these three dots. Adobe Express has now got really legitimately good video editing capabilities. You can show a layered timeline to really give yourself an idea. You could change this. So I could just change it to the font that works for me. I could change the text by editing it here. I could just, instead of saying Ridgewood College Theater Club, I could say Andrew can, and I could change Theater Club to Going Live. Again, keeping this with my branding, I could change a lot on this. I can maybe say this, the time, I don't really have one, but if I really wanted to take this to the next level, you notice on the left-hand side, there are text effects as well. So I could just easily say, you know, make this Andrew can, but make it out of soup cans, because of course can and can. I can then choose, you know, keep the font. If you also need help, there are lots of sample effects you can use, but I'm gonna use the one I said. I'm gonna keep them tight. I'm just gonna generate. We are gonna generate this text here, and it's gonna go from what it was to a bunch of soup cans. Now from here, I can make this a little bit larger. Of course, obviously this is for an Instagram story, so this probably wouldn't work too perfect, but you get the idea. It's now my name out of soup cans. This is something that didn't exist before and now exists. And if I wanted to, another cool feature is you can now animate, right? So I can animate this font. I could use a looping font. I could make it jitter. I could make it blink. I could make it pulse like that. And there's so much you can do. Maybe I would do more of a flicker effect to match kind of the lighting. I can then, as this is coming in, you can see it bungees in, flickers, the light comes around it, and then it bungees out. And all of those effects are right here. And that's super cool. And all of this is stuff you can be doing and trying right now in the Adobe Express beta. And I just get so passionate about it because it's so cool. There's another cool thing you can do. Let's say I really love this image. You know, this is something I'm proud of. I'm working with a team. You can click up here and share. And in real time, you can both edit this together. And that's the cool thing. So if I wanted to invite my friend, they wanted to look here and edit. I'll show you what that looks like a little bit on screen. But that is just, again, another really cool feature. And I cannot tell you enough how excited I am to see the direction Adobe Express is going.
And that's the beta version of Adobe Express. As you can see, there are so many cool new features that you can start using today. If you'd like to learn what Adobe Express features you could get started with, check out that video on screen with 5 features to get you started using Adobe Express. From the bottom of my heart, I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who has watched and supported this channel. Without you, partnerships like this one with Adobe wouldn't be possible. So thank you. Because of you, I can too.